So we went to check out to the White Wolf Inn and the door's locked. So for record, there's the key. It's 7:30. Let's go try and catch a shuttle. This is the lovely little town of Stratton. It's actually pretty cool. It really reminds us of West Virginia. Bunch of ATVs. They had like a festival going on yesterday. It's pretty wild. Also, whoopie pies for breakfast. Thanks to Ned and Karen.
I'm saving mine for my morning snack.
I just devoured that whoopie pie. And then I looked on the back to see the nutritional value of it. I just had 820 calories in about 5 minutes for breakfast. Thanks again, Ned and Karen. Good late morning. It is day 20. It's Sunday. And I think it's June 25th. June 25th. And I can't remember the name of the mountain we're hiking up, but man, it's rough. We're just not feeling it today. We stayed in Stratton last night, and we got back to the trail at 8 this morning. It feels like we got about 60 pounds in our bag today. Yeah, we didn't even add anything. Well, she added Doritos, I added Pringles. So, just keep going up. We are almost at the top, and it's North Crocker Mountain. It's like 4,200 feet. We got like 300 feet to go up in 0.3 miles. We are going out to the view. We're at North Crocker Mountain. Oh my god, does the view just. The trail keeps going and going and going.
I'm not going any further.
Yeah, I don't really care too either. But. Yeah, it's pretty-ish. I mean, it is pretty. Not much of a view, though.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're at South Crocker, and that's Sugarloaf right there. That's what we'll be going over, I think, the right side of that tomorrow. Could do it today, but just not feeling it. Not feeling it. So. We made it down, or well, we're making it down the mountain. There's Sugarloaf behind that tree. Shannon, charging forward. This is really pretty. And of course, as soon as we get out from the forest, it starts to rain. Good morning. It is day 21, Monday, June 26th, and we get to start off the day crossing a river and then going up a giant mountain. This is the East Karabasset River. Nothing like, what is it, 1,500 foot or 2,000 that we gotta climb? Yeah. We've been hiking for 30 minutes. Fun!
Yay.
We're getting there, almost to the top. Well, we are walking up the backside of Sugarloaf Mountain. I think it's the second tallest mountain in Maine. And just on the other side of that peak right there is a ski resort. Hey, Shannon.
Hey.
Well, there's kind of the backside of Sugarloaf. Just over that tree line is where all the runs are. Here's yet another mountain. Shannon doesn't want to climb. 150 yards. That's nothing. That's nothing.
It says backslash
yeah. Nova. Yeah, somebody wrote on there. Yeah, so we're definitely not going up.
So we hit 200 miles. There's supposed to be a plaque. That was like the joining of the AT going from.
The completion of the AT.
Yeah, the completion. That was like the completion spot, I guess. Or the. Just a plaque commemorating it. Walked right by it. And it was in pine trees.
Yep.
So. Whatever, we took a picture at mile 200, didn't see a black, whatever. woo, 1900 and...
89 or something.
Yeah, 1,990 miles to go.
Okay, go again. What were you thinking about last night?
All of the different foods that I was going to eat. Like, I was trying to figure out if we could pack out some salami and pepperoni and make an Italian sub. Oh, I was just going to get a bag of like spinach and a bottle of dressing.
Someone's getting a little tired of Cliff Bar's tortilla and tuna.
Yeah. I was thinking English muffin and maybe cheese for breakfast. I don't know.
I don't know if you can hear it. Probably not. But there's a constant zzzz on top of the mountain. I bet there is probably a trillion bugs out here. Probably a trillion. Not even exaggerating.
Don't get my dirty hair on video.
Well, now that's going in. Well, we have been transported into what reminds us of Pennsylvania. Kind of weird. Making our way downtown.
Walking fast.
Faces passing, I'm homebound. 4 miles to the shelter. Just gotta go down a gorge and
up a mountain.
Up a mountain. And then tomorrow we do the saddlebacks. Woo! Little baby squirrel. Super cute. And now we get to go down. Very down. We are within a mile and we get to rock climb.
Yay.
How do you feel about that climb? Same. Poplar Ridge, like 0.2 from camp.
Yep.
Sweet. Let's go. We've made it to Poplar Lean 2. You can see it over there. Hi, Shannon. There's your tent. Made it from 196.6 to where we are now, 210 something. Okay. 209?
Yeah.
Yeah. And then tomorrow we got like 9 miles, I think.
Yeah.
We gotta go over a bald. So that'll be fun. It's bald for like 2.5 miles. So here's to hoping we don't have bad weather.
That's great. We got snoring over there.
The birds.
If you hear that. Yeah, and the birds. And then up that way, there's a group of 9 boys with 2 counselors that are in like college. They're like 100 yards away. They're just screaming and yelling, so.
It's hiker midnight.
Yeah. It's 8:30, 8:45.
It's cold.
And it's very cold, as you can tell from she being bundled up. I'm hardly moving, it's not even straight. Gonna represent the mo.
So. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. It is day 22, June 27th, and it's Tuesday?
Mm-hmm.
Got it. We left at like 7:05. It was a rather chilly morning. So,
very interesting morning thus far.
Yeah, it's been a very interesting morning, I'll say. We got like 10 miles to Rangeley, I think, or to the road, and then 9 miles to Rangeley, so we're going to try and hitch. We're thinking going into Rangeley today. We'll get there.
If we get there by noon, we're going to try to go in.
Yeah, which I think we should be able to, but, you know,
And it turns out the kids weren't too loud last night. I didn't really hear them once it got dark.
That's because you fell asleep.
Yeah, I did fall asleep. I guess they might have been loud.
Yeah, they were loud.
We woke up to some two very, very angry squirrels. They were like hissing and jittering at us, like right above our tent. And we were slightly worried they got into our food bag, but nope.
Squirrels are crafty.
Very, very. Oh, and exciting news. 2 days ago, moved a belt notch.
Woo.
I'm pretty excited about it. So. Ready?
Yep.
See you down the trail.
Yet again, Maine provides us with some awesome rock climbing. It's a cool little birdie. We're almost to the top of Saddleback Junior, and you can, I don't know if you can see it, ooh, that's shaky, but right there is Sugarloaf. We were there yesterday evening, afternoon, and that's quite a ways away. It's pretty up here. The top of Saddleback Junior. Oh my god. I tried running to catch up. That's a bad idea.
Oh, I wanted to get up here and be like, yeah! Before you got up here, but then I turned around, you were behind me.
Too quick for you, Shannon. Keep that in mind when you think about cheating on me. Those are the next two mountains we gotta go. And then we dip down. And then we'll be in Rangeley before too long. There's a bunch of wind farms over there if you can see them. Wow. Yeah, Switchback was right. It is gorgeous up here.
Alright, let's go before.
There's Saddleback Junior over there. We just walked up, or down, and then back up. We're almost at the top, but. We are now above tree line. Top's up there.
The next like 2 miles or so. 3 miles?
2.5. Sugarloaf's way over there in the distance. We just hit the first bald. It's up there. There's a lot of people though. So I think that's Rangeley over there. I'm not too sure. But you can see where we're going next. There's Shannon trudging. This is absolutely stunning.
You should have paused when I was skipping.
Oh yeah. You can still skip.
Oh no.
There's some flat stuff up there. Shannon was skipping. So there's another little town right there. I don't know if that's like a ski slope. I think I can see some runs. But if we weren't boogieing to town, I would definitely stop for a bit. It is pretty. We get to go all the way up that. That's the last mountain for the day. And then we get to go down, down, down. And we can see folks up there. Two of them going south, two of them coming north. Yep, we started over on that middle mountain, hit that one, walked all the way down, and then we gotta go all the way back behind Shannon. If you can see there are two folks over there. Those are them section hikers that are sprinting.
Almost there.
Almost there. I'm gonna hop up on this big rock. We beat the rain. Nah, we don't. Well, I mean, we beat the rain up here. I'm not worried about it down there. And we can still kind of see Sugarloaf. It's that peak right in the middle. This is the Saddleback mountain range, by the way. And back to the beginning. Well, we made it to the top of Saddleback. There's a sign over there. I saw this rock pile. I was like, what is this? And I guess a bunch of people built up, like, basically a little shelter from the wind. Because I'm sure it gets windy up here. We rushed to beat the rain. So we're pretty happy about that. Might rain on us before we get to Rangeley. But now we just got to go over to that peak over there. And then go down for about 5.5 miles.
We have made it to Piazza Rock Lean-To. It's like 12:40, and we got 1.8 left until we get to the parking lot at Maine 4. So we're within an hour of town. Well, an hour of hopefully getting to town. I still got to get a hitch, and then I think we're gonna try and stay at the farmhouse inn. They've got like a kitchen and stuff, so we're probably just gonna cook our own food tonight. I don't know what we're gonna do for lunch. I kind of just want to get something fast because, I mean, it's already 12:40. We won't get there for, we won't get into town for probably another hour. So I'm hoping we can just order something fast. Maybe they got like a deli or something like that. We can just order some subs and then eat it before we take showers, even though we smell pretty ripe. But this is like one of the nicest shelters I've seen so far. I'll give you a lookie. And then there's the shelter. I mean, it looks very nice. The toilet's up that way. Apparently it's got 2 seats. But yeah, I mean, it doesn't smell bad. I mean, as you can see, there's spider webs galore, like always. But it's kind of nice.
Red lights right there is an awesome person. We got our first hitch. If Shannon would start running, we could get there faster. We're trotting.
So the first hitch that we got into Rangeley was Looney Laura, and she's a real sweet lady. Looney Lori. And she gave herself her own trail name. She hasn't done the trail yet, but she's a super nice lady, and it's because she really likes loons, and she actually had a loon tattooed on her leg, which is how we found out the magical ducks were loons and not magical ducks. And then we got a second hitch when we were at the laundromat, and it just started dumping in the rain, and we were going like 200 feet across the street, and this dude Paul just was coming in and out checking on his laundry. And then as soon as we go to head out the door, he's like, hey, you guys hiking the trail? We're like, yeah. And then he's like, well, I can give you a ride. Where are you going? We're like, we're just going across the street to Sarge's. He was like, hey, it's raining, I'll give you a ride. I'm like, dude, it's like 200 feet away, we can see the sign. He's like, nah, don't worry about it. So we hopped in his car, he drove down the street, turned around and dropped us off. It was like curbside service. So Looney Lori and Paul, two super awesome people in Rangeley. But we're at the Hikers Welcome Hostel right now. Hopefully they have good Wi-Fi so I can upload at least one video. So, woo!
Taking a video, weirdo. Got Henry in the background there.
It is day 23, and we made breakfast. We're at the Farmhouse Inn. And it is quite nice. But yeah, breakfast. So good. He's pounding down, loaded up and trucking. Are we gonna do what they say can't be done? We've got a long way to go and a short time to get there. I'm eastbound, just watch no bandit run. Keep your foot hard on the pedal, some hell will mind them brakes. Let it all hang out, cause we got a run to make. The boys are thirsty in Atlanta, and there's beer in Texarkana, and we'll bring it back no matter what it takes. Eastbound and down, loaded up and trucking. Are we gonna do what they say can't be done? We've got a long way to go, and a short time to get there. I'm eastbound, just watch your band.